Was you who dubbed me into the police, wasn't it?
There's a law against hitting people you don't approve of. Or didn't you know?
Yeah, I knew Jim wouldn't have done it. It had to be you. They picked me up in the golf club. Do you have any idea how I felt?
Do you know how that man feels with a broken nose and a ruptured spleen?
He wasn't a man, he was a poofter.
How did you get away from the police?
I walked away. They asked me if I'd beaten a bloke up in a public toilet. I said no and they believed me.
They believed you?
Well, why wouldn't they? I'm an honest citizen with a good army record. Anyway, I was telling the truth.
Like hell.
There I was on the ninth green when they came to get me. Partnered with Colonel Woodward. Damn fine golfer, the Colonel. Mind you, it really put him off his game when he saw the fuzz stomping all over the green. They carted me off like a common crim.
You're worse than a common criminal. You only joined the army for the nice legal killing.
Fine,
you touch me, and the police won't believe you this time.
We'll be moving to Mingwes this afternoon with our own little guard of honor.
Can't be soon enough for me.
Morning, Redwood. Did you hear that, Dominguez? You'll soon be on the move again. And seeing as you seem to like the company of desperados, we're going to put you in the men's jail. Maximum security wing. Pity your friends had all their trouble for nothing.
They won't fail next time.
You know you lost a man.
That one was always careless.
I wouldn't say that the others were crash hot. Da Costa's trigger happy, and Cooper's all mouth.
Who?
Oh, you know who. The clowns who tried to break you out of Wentworth. If they're typical of your lot, I don't know why you bother.
They still got one of your men.
But they failed in their mission. Failed miserably, and you're still here.
I wouldn't be if it weren't for that stupid girl.
Where is she?
Who?
Come on, Dominguez. She's not one of your mob. We want her back before she gets into any more trouble.
There's an indictment of your society. A woman is better off in jail than she is on your streets.
You must have been a woman before you were a terrorist. Come on, let's hear it for sisterhood.
If it wasn't for that squeamish little bitch, your precious governor would be dead. And at least we'd have accomplished something. I wish Rosalind Colson in hell.
Hello, Princess. Changed your mind?
Maybe. Sailing soon?
We're off to Brisbane in an hour. So we can't waste any time, can we?
Would you like to take me with you?
To Brizzy? Yeah, I could fix that.
Thank you.
Brisbane's a long way, so we could have a real cosy trip, you and me. What's your name?
Debbie.
Okay, Debbie. What are you drinking?
Could I have the money instead?
How much?
A dollar. I'll meet you at the entrance to the pier in half an hour, okay?
Sure. What have I got to lose except a dollar? Guess what? I just bought for a dollar.
I'll have 20 cents for it.
It's not the quickest route, but it's the safest.
But in a laundry van, that's hardly impregnable.
Well, this one is.
Come in.
Excuse me, sir. It's Latham again.
You mean she's thought of something?
She's thought of another way to waste your time.
Never mind, Miss Bennett. We must keep fossicking. Bring her in.
I've worked it out. Where'd she go?
Well, go on, Chrissy.
Well, she asked me once what I'd do if I ever shot through. I told her I'd try and pick up a boat going interstate.
Stow away?
Yeah. Well, she'd be all right with the sailor for a ticket.
Yes. Yes, a pretty girl like Colson wouldn't have any trouble. Well, thank you, Chrissy. Now, you can go away and think some more. There might be other things you've talked about that you've forgotten.
Well, do I get any remission for this?
Oh, if we catch her, definitely.
You can't promise her remission. You haven't got the authority.
It's not my fault if you lot can't keep my promises.
Hello, love. You look done in.
Oh, hello, Jeff.
I heard about the kerfuffle down at Wentworth. Front page news, eh?
Yes. Yes, I suppose it was.
I did ring and they said you were on the way home, so I thought I'd take you out to lunch. Put the roses back in your cheeks.
Oh, no, Jeff, I'm just too tired.
Well, you'll feel better after a good lunch.
No, thanks. I just want to curl up and die.
Well, what about if I go to a takeaway?
Look, I'm not hungry. I just want to sleep.
But you've got to eat.
Not today. Please, Jeff.
You're trying to brush me off?
No. Well, yes, maybe I am.
Well, you'd better have a good reason.
I just don't think it's going to work out.
Well, now, that doesn't sound like my girl, Meg. Now, why don't we just talk this thing over reasonably, shall we?
Around, get him out of the way. Tell him the forecastle's on fire. Well, Princess, how'd you spend your dollar?
Here's the change.
Nah, keep it. You're a bit nervous, aren't you? New to the game?
Yes.
Come on, love, relax.
Excuse me, you're Rosalind Coulson?
No, you got the wrong Sheila, mate. This is Debbie, so piss off. Come on, mate. He's not from your old man or something.
Miss Coulson knows who we are.
It's like there's been times when I've been too tired to be rational. Why don't you just drink your drink and give us a big smile, eh?
I want out, Jeff.
Well, that's a bit of a change of pace, isn't it?
I had time to think.
Has Leela had anything to do with your thinking?
It's got nothing to do with Leela. I've just got over one emotional disaster. I'm not prepared to try again.
Oh, crap!
Look, I can't take that risk.
Leela's really been getting to you, hasn't she?
I can make my own decisions.
And you've decided not to see me again. And you made the decision all on your own, right?
Yes.
Good. I just wanted to get things straight, that's all.
So, will you please go now?
No. No, I don't think I will. Sit down.
Now it's your turn to get something straight. Nobody, but nobody gives me the boot.
Do you understand, girl?
Hey, Bert, look who's here. It's that Dominguez bitch, the one who shot the governor. I hope you rot, you commie bitch.
Why don't you go and blow up your own country?
Yeah, why don't you bloody politics to yourself?
Leela, where are you?
Here.
Well, you certainly made a fool of me today, didn't you? Ringing Meg after I told you not to.
Well, somebody had to tell her. You're obviously too busy as usual.
I told you I'd go to the police about Jeff.
But you just couldn't find the time.
I rang them. I told them my suspicions and left it at that.
So it was you then?
Who else?
He told me he was picked up at the golf course by the police. He thought I'd dobbed him in.
They let him go?
Amazing, isn't it?
But he must be innocent.
Innocent? He practically told me he did it. It wasn't a man, he said. It's only a poofter.
Where is he now?
I don't know. He went out.
Out? Where?